introduction. Of the introduction, thank you. Thank you very much. It's a great pleasure to be back under slightly different guise in this room. Here we are. Hope you all enjoyed your cup of tea. It's amazing to me how lovely it's been made macker. And people keep stopping me in the streets of wherever I am, Manchester, Cambridge, London, and saying, "Congratulations, macker!" So it seems to have captured people's imagination in a strange way. That I hadn't expected that. It's a bit exposing. Yes, you can't go out as a macker without the makeup on. Just a baby to run into. Anyway, it's also a wonderful thing being Chancellor of the University of Salford, which I was made last year, and there's an event this Thursday that I'm doing or hosting in Salford in the library on Thursday at 4:00. If anybody wants to try and come along to that, it'd be wonderful. I'm going to start with a Scottish poem. It was really striking in the competition how many different entries there were from Scotland, and some of the poems were just fantastic. But you could see, couldn't you, hearing those three wonderful poems, that the quality of really good poems just rises up. So I'd like to thank these three poets once more. I think they were fantastic. Feels vindicating as a judge, you know, when you actually see poets in real life and you hear the poems, or you actually hear them as well as read them, and your choices are vindicated. Zafir Cunion, who's here, told me they were sound choices, so I took that. That's good. So this is a poem called A Lang Promise. There might be a lot of Scottish words in this poem that some of you might not understand, but that's life. Whether the weather be bleak or fair, my love, if good times greet us or we hate to face the worst, a hint and a fore what will happen to us, blind in the present, eyes open to the fury, unkempt or sharply dressed, suddenly poor or poorly, peely wally, or in fine feckle, in dark December, in springy spring weather, down by the barrows, on the banks of the Champs-Élysées, at midnight, first light, whether the moon be round or crescent, and ye be of sound mind or absent, I'll tap your trusty wand and lead you over the hall, hame, my darling. I'll carry my lantern and door defend you again ony enemy, and whilst there's breath in me, I'll blow it into you. For ye are my true love, the bonny face I see afore me. Nicks I fall into slumber, it's you I see swimmingly, all your goodness and blindness, your passion. You'll be mine new until the end of time, my bonnie lassie. I'll tack the full gear of you and gate back to you. My first kiss, a lying promise, time's golden ring. Would Jane Eyre come to the information desk? So I rushed along to the information desk. Seems an appropriate poem to read in this year of centenaries. Would Jane Eyre come to the information desk? The speaker voice at Heathrow Airport said. I stood and waited for her to appear. Jane Eyre. And when she came near, she was shouting, "My name is Bertha. My name is not Jane Eyre. I come from Kingston, Jamaica. Look here." Well, they placed handcuffs on her. Ras. She shook her black hair and stamped her feet in anger. "I have as much soul as you," she was shouting at the immigration officer, "and full as much heart. My name is Bertha." And the man was waving a form in front of her face, saying, sign here, Jane Eyre. Stop shouting, dear, or you'll end up in holding." And Bertha was dignity, quality. Know what I'm saying? I am no bird, and no net ensnares me. I am a free human being with an independent will, she said in a voice come down from a century. For a minute, I thought I was dreaming, but wait! Just as suddenly as she appeared, by information she disappeared, pulled across the floor, kicking, screaming, and a long queue instantly forming like a giant question across Terminal 4, and people saying the same thing, appalling, the way they treat that woman, poor thing, who was she, who was Jane Eyre, who was Bertha, and the information people saying over and over, "We're not at liberty to say anything." We are not at liberty, know what I'm saying? And it's me they're accusing of paranoia. Ding, ding. When you hear that name on the loudspeaker calling, "Would Jane Eyre come here?" You know, it's a crazy, crazy world we're living in.
It is you. It is me.
it will stroke your hand when you die. This is called The Red Graveyard. I was thinking about the blues singer Bessie Smith when I wrote this, but also just about that thing that your mind does when you listen to music, that you make up narratives and you make up stories and they all get mixed together. And I used to really absolutely love watching the way that people respond to music, like I did today, just watching people's different facial expressions and the way that they kind of move along with it. And I used to love watching my dad in particular, listening to jazz, because he'd always give it the serious jazz face and tapping his feet, dancing and, you know, doing that thing as if he was partly conducting it privately in his own living room in Glasgow. The Red Graveyard. There are some stones that open in the night like flowers, down in the red graveyard where Bessie haunts her lovers. There are stones that shake and weep in the heart of night, down in the red graveyard where Bessie haunts her lovers. Why do I remember the blues? I'm 5 or 6 or 7 in the back garden. The window is wide open. Her voice is slow motion through the heavy summer air. Jelly roll, kitchen man, sausage roll, frying pan. Inside the house, when I used to be myself, her voice claims the rooms. In the best room even, something has changed the shape of my silence. Why do I remember her voice and not my own mother's? Why do I remember the blues? I'm coming down the stairs in my father's house. I'm 5 or 6 or 7. There is fat, thick wallpaper I always caress, bumping flower into flower. She is singing. Did they play anyone else, ever? My father's feet tap a shiny beat on the floor. Christ, my father says, that's some voice she's got. I pick up the record cover, and now this is slow motion. My hand swoops, glides, swoops again. I pick up the cover, and my fingers are all over her face. Her black face, her magnificent black face. That's some voice. His shoes dancing on the floor. There are some stones that open in the night like flowers. Down in the red graveyard where Bessie haunts her lovers. There are stones that shake and weep in the heart of night. Down in the red graveyard where Bessie haunts her lovers. See how it goes. And this poem, may as well stick with the idea of people being departed and people being lost to us in some way. It was very recently the anniversary of my dear friend Julia Darling, who came to Manchester and did a lot of readings, and I was also thinking of Linda France. One of the last times that I saw Linda was when I was walking through Beach Road Park in Charlton, where I live, and she was playing with her grandchildren on a day kind of much like this day. And it wasn't really that long after that she died, because that part was all very sudden. But anyway, she had a great joyous presence. Linda, so I like to think of her being here too, enjoying this day and enjoying the music, and how what what you put in place, I suppose, for people, what you can leave behind. So this is called Darling. You might forget the exact sound of her voice or how her face looked when sleeping. You might forget the sound of her quiet weeping, curled into the shape of a half moon. When smaller than herself, she seemed already to be leaving before she left, when the blossom was in the trees and the sun was out and all seemed good in the world. I held her hand and sang a song from when I was a girl. Here we are, go boys, let her go boys. And when I stopped singing, she had slipped away, already a slip of a girl again, skipping off, her heart light, her face almost smiling. And what I didn't know or couldn't say then was that she hadn't really gone. The dead don't go till you do, loved ones. The dead are still here, holding our hands. A very wee poem that I wrote for my grandfather, Joseph Kay, who was a prisoner of war and who got injured in the First World War. And years later, like 40 years later, his arm swole out quite massively. And he went to the doctor, and the doctor cut the arm open, and inside was a little piece of shrapnel. And it kind of, I thought that was really extraordinary, the way that your body holds stories, literally holds stories. So this is called bantam. And you might know that word bantam. It just means wee, really. It means wee. And there's all sorts of different kinds of bantams, cameras and everything, but anyway, it means wee. It was the men they sent to war. It was boys like the bantams. Wee men, named after small breeds of chickens, or later a jeep, a bike, a camera. That needy for soldiers, they draft height restriction, so small men came to war. As a prisoner, my father's weight fell, and years later, the shrapnel fray song shot out a wee jewel hidden in his right arm. I was trying to go with the rhyme there, and that rhyme song there. Zaf told me, thought it was there. So I'm just going to finish, and thank you very, very much, Whites and Players, for having me as your judge this year. It was a huge pleasure. I think it's a really wonderful organisation, and lovely, kind of almost a freeing organisation that just allows all things to be possible. For people to come in all sorts of states of mind and hopefully feel accompanied through whatever it is that you're going through in life. And then recently, this last year, I've had quite a hard year because both my parents got ill at the same time. We both ended up in the same hospital, Glasgow Royal Infirmary. In fact, they were too ill to visit each other from ward to ward, so they wrote each other letters, and a porter carried them back and forth. Isn't that so lovely? I have yet to write a poem about the porter's letters, but I think there's a poem in there somewhere. And I'm very proud of the fact that they've been married and full of love for each other for 60 years. It seems to me an extraordinary achievement, 60 years of marriage. Anyway, my mum, they're fine now, my mum. When she came out of hospital, I had to get her a Zimmer. So I got her a really quite stylish Zimmer because she's quite trendy. My mom used to be doing dances in her Zimmer, dance moves on it and everything. Anyway, she went to the hairdresser with this poppy red Zimmer and she said, "Jackie, you should have seen me in the hairdressers, all the women crowding down my Zimmer. Talk about Zimmer envy."
Simmer rage, more like simmer rage.
So I wrote this anyway as a song. It's originally sung by a soprano singer, put to music by a composer called Colin Waters, as part of a festival or a concert at the Royal Festival Hall. Notes to the New Government, it was supposed to be called. So this is it. April sunshine. Here we are in April, and it was shining. When people who've lived all of their lives for democracy, survive to see the springtime, April sunshine, it's a blessing. It's a blessing. In the hospital, this bleak midwinter, you were just an old woman. You were just an old man. Nobody imagined how you marched against Polaris, how you sat down at Dunoon, stood up for UCS. Nobody pictured you writing to Mandela and 50 other prisoners of South Africa. In the hospital, this bleak midwinter, you were just an old woman. You were just an old man. Nobody knew how you greeted Madame Allende or sang the songs of Victor Jara or loved Big Arthur's Bravura, Bandiera Rosa, or heard Paul Robeson at the May Day rally. You were just an old woman. You were just an old man. Nobody knew you saw all of 784, the Steamy and the Bevelers opening nights, how you cried with laughter, how you stood up for the arts, how you stood up for the arts. In the hospital, throughout this long winter, you were just an old woman. You were just an old man. How you went to concerts every Friday at Razmat, and how just last Saturday you were mad. You couldn't march against Trident with Nicola Sturgeon. You say, one less missile will subsidise the arts for a century. You say, which politician will stand up for the arts? You would have struggled with your new grey stick. You would have walked with your poppy red Zimmer to march against Trident once more, to march against Trident stridently. What do we want, you say? Peace in society, time has not made your politics dimmer. When the people who've lived all of their lives for democracy, survive to see the springtime, April sunshine, it's a blessing. It's a blessing.